Okay, guys, so this problem is what I call the rocket problem here. So this problem does pertain to factoring. So it's kind of one of those word problems, those application problems that they might give you after teaching you how to factor here. So really, let's just get into the problem and let's read on it and stuff. That way we can see what situation we have here, how we're gonna solve this thing. So most rocket problems are very similar. So let's just go through this and see what we have to do. So this problem says, if an object is propelled straight upward from ground level with an initial velocity of 112 feet per second, its height, represented by the letter h, in feet after t seconds later, is given by the following equation. So here they gave us this equation. So this equation represents the height, the projection of what this rocket or whatever it is that they propelled is going to go, right? Kind of its motion. And what the question is asking us here, it says after how many seconds, all right, so we're solving 4 seconds, after how many seconds is the height 96 feet? So they want to know after shooting whatever it is from the ground, right? Let's just pretend it's a rocket. All right. So after shooting this rocket up from the ground, how long will it take it to reach 96 feet is what this particular question is asking us here. So what we needed to do with this problem here, well, first off, we need to start with the equation that they gave us. All right, so here's our equation. H is equal to negative 16t squared plus 112t. And it wants us to figure out, well, how long is it gonna take it to reach 96 feet? So they gave us the height, right? They gave us, hey, I wanna know when it's 96 feet in the air, okay? What we need to figure out is the time, how many seconds it took. So looking at this equation here, they gave us h. We can plug into h here. What we're trying to figure out is we're trying to solve for t. So I'm just gonna move this equation down over here, right? And what we're gonna do is we're gonna plug in the information that we know, and let's see if we can figure out, you know, how do we figure out the rest of it? So we got that h is 96 feet. So I'm gonna plug that into this problem right over here. Now, I don't know about you, but if I have to solve for t here, well, I see that I have more than one t here. So obviously our steps of solving an equation is not going to work. I can't like subtract 112t from both sides or do something like that. There's no possible way I'm going to get t by itself because, hey, I got two of them here. Okay, so just kind of a little hint here. When you are dealing with equations like this, hopefully you've noticed this little exponent over here too. So this little exponent here tells me that this is a quadratic equation. And the first thing that we should always look for when we're given a quadratic equation here is let's see if we can factor this thing. If we can factor this thing, it's gonna make life easier for us. But if I'm gonna try and factor this first off, well, it needs to be in proper quadratic form, which means everything needs to be on one side. I need to get this thing set equal to zero. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna subtract 96 from both sides. And that's gonna put it in proper quadratic form for me. So here I'll have zero is equal to negative 16t squared plus 112t minus 96. So now that it's in proper quadratic form, now we can try and figure out, well, how are we gonna factor this thing here? And when it comes to factoring, there is one thing that you should always look for before going into your actual factoring techniques, and that is a greatest common factor. So always look and see, do you have a greatest common factor in the problem? So I can tell you right now that we definitely do have a greatest common factor, and actually one other thing that's very important to notice about this problem here is that we have a negative here in front. And hopefully we do maybe remember a rule that says when your leading term is negative, you're gonna need to factor that out as part of your greatest common factor. So as part as my greatest common factor, I'm gonna say, hey, I need that negative to be a part of it. Then looking over my problem here, starting with our numbers, 16, 112, 96, and we need to figure out, is there a number they have in common? Now these are slightly big numbers, but you know what? 16 happens to be the greatest common factor here. The fact that this 16 here is in front, I mean, I kind of just started with that one and tested it out, and 16 actually does go into 112. It does go into 96. So if you need help with that, maybe pull out your calculator and just see and divide each one of these by 16, and you see that it works out nice and perfect. So negative 16 is our greatest common factor because we don't have a t in all three of our terms, and that's fine. So we're going to factor out a negative 16, right? We're going to pull it out to the front. And remember, that's the same thing as dividing it out from everything. So we can figure out what's going to be left over when we pull out the negative 16. So when we divide that out to figure that out, let's see, negative over negative cancels, 16 over 16 cancels, and we can drop down the t squared. Middle term here, well, positive over a negative is negative, and 112 divided by 16, I believe, is 7 there, and drop down the t. And then over here, negative over negative is positive, and 96 divided by 16 is a 6. So far this is what we have. 0 is equal to a negative 16, and then we have our trinomial here. So all we've done so far is pulled out a negative 16 as a greatest common factor here. Now we gotta keep going here. We still are left with this trinomial here, so what we need to do is we need to see, can that factor? So taking a look at this trinomial here, all right, so we have a trinomial with the leading term of 1, so I use reverse FOIL in order to do this. Our first spot's here. Remember, that's what times what gives you t squared, and the only way to get t squared is a t times a t. Then we move over to our last term, which is the 6, and we think of all the combinations of numbers that are going to multiply to get 6. And all we have is a 1 times a 6 or a 2 times a 3. And we want the combination that's going to add or subtract for our middle term, which is a 7, which tells us we have to use the 1 and the 6. Then looking at our signs, whatever sign your middle term has, the bigger one out of these has to have it, so that's going to go with a 6. And because this last term over here is positive, the only way to get a positive in multiplication is with same signs. Same signs positive, different signs negative. So because this is positive, that tells me these have to have the same sign. So these are, or this is my factored quadratic equation over here. Now at this point here, now is where we could actually finally do some solving and actually figure out what our solutions are going to be here. Now that we have it completely factored, what we do is we're going to use the zero factor property that's going to let us know that, hey, we can take these factors and split them up and set them each equal to zero so we can solve. So you only split up factors that have variables in them. So the negative 16, we don't need to do anything with that. What we're going to do is we're going to take these two factors here and we're going to set them each equal to zero, and we're going to solve both of them. So we're going to solve these two equations here, and our solutions for this is going to be our solutions for our entire problem here. So in order to solve this one here, I'm going to add 1 on both sides. So t is equal to 1, and then I'm going to add 6 to both sides, and t is going to equal 6. Now what this tells us right here, remember that we were solving for time, and it says how many seconds did it take for it to reach 96 feet. So this tells us that after 1 second and after 6 seconds is when this was 96 feet high. So think about it, if you're going to project something from the ground, right, it's going to come up, right, and then eventually it's going to have to come back down. Right, so you're going to kind of do this upside down parabola thing over here. Right, so at 1 second, it reached that 96 feet. And then at six seconds is when it was coming down over here. So then it hit 96 feet again. So both of these are our solutions here. 1 second and 6 seconds. Had you happened to get a situation where you would have got a negative number for this here, you would have automatically marked that answer choice out because you can't have negative seconds. So in this kind of problem, if you ever get a negative here, you just know, hey, that's not right. You need to go with a positive answer if that happens to happen. But for here, it's 1 second and 6 seconds.